Thank you for choosing Sure Thing to travel on your getaway trip. Welcome to the operational instructions video. This video will cover everything you need to know about how to prepare, operate and maintain our high top camper van. We will ensure you experience an exciting and hassle-free adventure in Australia.
Before you travel, don't forget to put things away from the benches and close all the doors. Also, before you travel, don't forget to shut the sunroof. To start the van, turn the key halfway through until the lights go on and wait for the orange to go off. And then you can run the engine. Change your gears. You're gonna start on P. Then you press the button to pull back and goes to reverse, neutral, and fourth. Don't go further than fourth. Drive the whole time on fourth gear. And don't forget to change the gear. You press the button and you go back to the original parking position.
It runs in diesel only, and to access the diesel cap, you just open the passenger door, open the hatch, and take the lid off. And don't forget to use diesel only, and if you by accident put another kind of petrol, contact Camplify or contact us through our phones.
This van is 2.5 meters high. You are not allowed to go into drive-thrus or shopping under the shopping centers. When you are about to park anywhere, just take care of the height again, because hanging trees can damage the roof. When you are about to park, try to use the reversing mirrors, and there is a reversing camera inside of the van as well. And always ask for help if someone can help you. Looking at himself, but wishing he was someone else, because the posters on the wall, they don't look like a him. Ties it up, he tucks it in, he pulls it back and gives a grin, laughing at himself because he knows he ain't loved at all. So if your van is parked and is not leveled, you have two levels under the dinette seat where you're gonna put under the wheels. So you just place the ramp in front of the wheel and then you roll over. The van is leveled using these two levels here on the main entrance and the sliding door. So when you're stationary in a powered side, you just grab the lid, plug the lid on your main switch, which goes in this side here, and then you go to the side of the van. Once you are plugged outside in the main power of a powered side, it's really simple. You just put the mains down and everything in the van, all appliances, cooktop, we're gonna be working. A short thing is equipped with a toaster, with a frother, with a tea plunger and a kettle. Here is a grill. Here we have our fridge that runs in 240 or 12 volts, so it's gonna be always working. Microwave, where you're gonna use as a normal at your home. Here there is a pantry where you can store your food. So also here we have the coffee and tea drawer,
And then this I call the fun drawer, which we have some games, we have some picnic blanket, umbrella, shopping bags, fan, more lights. This is all storage for you. It's all empty. On this side here, we have our cutlery, utensils, and a little bit of wraps and cleaning stuff. There is much more cleaning stuff underneath the sink. In these drawers here in the middle, we have cups and plates. Second one here, we have some containers, we have some more cups and mugs. And in the bottom one, we have the pans and pots.
So to operate our cooktop, you just need to press on, and once you press on, you select the heat and the temperature. We recommend to use heat as low as 700, and then press heat and temperature again, and go temperature something in between 100 and 110. That's going to be enough to prepare your meals.
Water supply. There's this big bag here where you have two hoses. One hose to connect into the water. So if you need some plugs in different size, we keep them in this little toolbox. And also there is some extra tools here in case you need it. The water supply. And then connect this hose here. In this bit here. That's all. Just to connect to the sink. This goes underneath the fan here, where you just plug and then pull those two arms, and then you're gonna open everything. Goes straight from the sink to the drain. So if you go off-grid, we will supply 40 liters of fresh water. But if you run out, you need to connect the hose outside, as I showed before. And then you need to refill the tank. You come here, once it's connected outside, you just turn this tap here until the tank, you're gonna hear that the tank is fulfilled. To use our tap, you need to come here, put in off-grid auxiliary, and then you just turn the tap on, and every time you're gonna use it, you're gonna turn it on. So now I'm gonna show you how to put the awning to enjoy the outside area. So we get this bit here. Center bar. Right, that's gonna be second. You just hook the one that up there and fold these two things here, and then you can start with the extension. So to put the legs down, you just pull this bit here outside, and then you fold 9 degrees, close it up, and choose whatever height you want. Besides, we have another option. You put the leg down, and then you come here into the vent and connect the leg on the vent. To use the centerpiece, you just loosen up, hook on that particular bit. And then you come here, there's another same one as in this side here, and then you just extend and press the knob.
There's this hook here in one end.
You just put the hook somewhere here in the awning, and then there's two knobs, one in each side. Okay.
So to make your bed, you underneath the liner seat, there is two extra piece of wood where you're gonna place one right at the beginning here. Right, your middle one is gonna be your table. So you take the table out of its place, take the base out, and then your second half, your middle bit, is going to be your table. And the third and last bit is going to be the last piece of wood. After you set those three pieces of wood, you just fill up with the backrest. Yes, it's one in each side. One in the middle. Sorry, just set this one up. Put that one in. And you have your bed to enjoy. So our van also has what we call the breakfast table, where we can build, if you don't want to undo your bed at the back, so you can have your breakfast here. I'm gonna demonstrate how to do it. You can swing the seats around, but you just can't forget to put the handbrake down first. Handbrake down. And it's so, yes, it's so. Just a struggle in your mind. Swing around, the other one is gonna do the same thing. And then you first get the middle pole. And then you just get the little table to put in between those seats. Make sure that everything is back on its place, like awning, ramps, hoses. Make sure there's nothing attached to the van, and make sure that you also have a clear way to get out of your spot. Packing away, don't forget to get everything you take out of the van, all the attachments, all the accessories, everything. So Short Inc is equipped with all the safety gears you need. Here is your smoke alarm. Here is your fire extinguisher. And we also have underneath the passenger seat our first aid kit, where it's a fire blanket and also a whole kit with everything you need. My spare tire is located at the rear of the vehicle. Underneath the jack is located in the passenger seat. Right here, with everything you need.
If you do experience any mechanical difficulties along the way, please be advised that Camplify offers 24/7 roadside assistance. Please call Camplify Help and Support, and they will dispatch someone to assist you as soon as possible. Please be advised that smoking is not allowed at all times, and heavy penalties apply to any trace of smoke found within the vehicle. To avoid any charges, it's important to return the van clean and tidy. Before you return the van, empty any food contents from the fridge and cupboards. Clean cooking utensils and equipment. We hope you enjoy your trip on board of Sure Thing. If you have any questions while you're on your trip, please contact us or Campify. Thank you for watching this video. Will you have a great trip? Sure Thing.